Welcome to the lockdown lectures, where we are learning about the lives of some of Manchester's amazing researchers. Today we're joined by a Nobel Prize winning physicist, Professor Sir Kostya Novoselov. Born in Russia, Kostya won the Nobel Prize for his work isolating the properties of graphene at Manchester in 2004. Graphene has remarkable physical properties. It is the thinnest and strongest material ever discovered and has unique levels of light absorption and permeability. Graphene is generally thought to be a perfect membrane. It has electrical and thermal conductivity and is both flexible and stretchable. For years, scientists knew it existed but couldn't figure out how to extract it from graphite. Together with Professor Andre Geim, Kostya frequently held Friday night experiments, sessions where they would try out experimental science that wasn't necessarily linked to their day jobs. Playing around with some sticky tape and a lump of bulk graphite, they made their breakthrough. Kostya is the Langworthy Professor of Physics and Royal Society Research Professor at the University of Manchester. He is also an artist with an interest in traditional Chinese art and modern art, introducing the use of graphene ink into his paintings. Welcome, Kostya.
So I'm Kostya Novoselov. I'm a professor of physics at the University of Manchester and University of Singapore. Welcome to our lockdown lectures.
Io Shuffle asks, who inspired you to get into science?
Of course, it's very difficult. When I try to remember my childhood and how I turned to become a scientist, it's very difficult when you ask someone at the age of 14, 16, who you want to be. I could hardly understand what scientists do. To be honest, it's very difficult to determine what it takes to be a scientist and what scientists do, because it's not very trivial question at all. Because creating something new, it's a big statement, and not many people in the world who can claim that they're doing it professionally and at the highest possible level. So I was always very technical, and maybe I was confusing science was being technical, was becoming an engineer. But I always enjoyed doing things with my own hands, and I was doing some auto racing, some karting, and then gets excited about math and physics. So we in Russia we had quite a strong sieve of national Olympiads in physics and math, and I participated with reasonable, not very high success, but with reasonable success there, and that gave me a chance to get into the best university in Russia, and then I chose that, and then gradually I became a scientist. But as I said, understanding what does it take to be a scientist, still it takes a long time and probably not completely formed even up to now in my mind.
And Imad 2.4 would like to know, was the discovery of graphene an accident, and can you tell us a little bit more about your Friday night experiments?
Right. So I already said that I was lucky. I had very good teachers throughout my career, starting from school. Probably the most important teacher in my life is Andre Geim, so with whom I started to do my PhD in Holland some time ago. And Andre always had, and he has up to now, this interesting way of doing science through those small projects, which we called the Friday evening experiments, and it's really enjoyable working with him. And we had Andre is known for his levitation of frogs. We've been doing gecko tape together and magnetic water. So graphene was indeed one of those Friday evening experiments when you ask a question and you try to resolve it with minimum effort spent. If it works, that's great. If it doesn't work, you didn't waste too much time. And indeed, so graphene was one of those experiments which we tried, failed, and it didn't. We just almost forgot about this. And then the story was that I saw how people, I was just present in the lab when people were cleaning graphite to use in the scanning tunneling microscope as a sample. And I knew about this technique when they take a piece of graphite, cleave the top with the scotch tape and throw this scotch tape away. I've seen it many times before, but it's only when your brain is thinking about how to produce graphene, two and two comes together and you pick up this scotch tape from the dustbin and you make a transistor out of this. I should say that when we started to do that, we knew for sure, or at least I knew for sure, that graphene shouldn't exist. So we were making transistors out of graphite and we were enjoying studying their properties. And then when we made those devices which show some very special performance, and we couldn't explain their behavior, anything but that we have exactly a monolayer of graphene, then we really realized that we made this one atomic thick material. And I guess that's the, you can say that it was an accident, but accidents are important in science, first of all, but also accidents never happen accidentally. You need to create environment for those accidents happens. And that's the difference between a good scientist and a bad scientist. So the good scientist creates this environment for as many as possible those accidents happen.
Ahmed would like to know, do you still have the original piece of graphene that you created?
Well, as I said, we made our first device really, it was very quick and very, just within half an hour of picking up that scotch tape, we made the first device. It wasn't graphene at the time. It was still thin layer of graphite, but its properties were such that we knew that it's something interesting is going on. And it took us about a year to get to the first devices. And we were very lucky that we had a device which had one layer and two layer thick graphene, and they behave completely different. So that's how we knew. My guess, I still remember the name and I have pictures of those devices. My guess is that those first graphene devices, that we probably donated them to the Nobel Museum in Stockholm, and some of the previous devices we still have somewhere. Honestly, there are so many things going on with graphene. We rarely have time to look back. It's lots of things happening. We have over now, we probably have thousands of different devices, and we just keep looking forward with them.
And Kostya, you've had a really successful career. So how did it feel when you discovered that you'd won the Nobel Prize?
Well, of course, Nobel Prize is very special for any scientist, and different people cope with it differently. I try to set myself in such a way that I told myself not to change my lifestyle too much because of the prize, and keep doing what I'm doing, and it was reasonably successful. So we kept producing new results and keep producing more papers and discovering new interesting phenomena. And generally, I try not to mention the N word too much. So definitely I don't wake up in the morning and I don't check for the medal at all. So there are many there are many more things which we can work on right now. And people in the community, they also regard you not only for the prize, but also what you've done after that. And you always have to confirm that you are worthy of that.
And as we heard earlier, Kostya, you also have an interest in art. Do you think that art and science are closely related?
I think art and science are closely related in a sense that it takes creativity in both cases, and it takes a very special set of your mind, state of your mind, to create something new. And creating something new is really at the core of either science or art. Nobody is interested in repeating some masterpieces from before, and nobody is really interested in you repeating interesting but old famous experiment. And unfortunately, we don't know how to set your mind in such a conditions that it will start producing something new. Both artists and scientists, they have their own tricks, I'm sure. And so in that respect, it's very similar, but maybe the set of tricks would be different for the two professions.
And Kostya, you recently joined a graphene hackathon with the students at Manchester. What do you think makes Manchester and its students so special?
Well, what probably was the biggest, the most important outcome of the graphene development in Manchester is that there is now a very large and very enthusiastic community around graphene in Manchester. And of course, it's the team, the graphene team, grew dramatically since the time we've been working. We started to work on this in 2003. So there were only a few people there, myself, Andre Geim, Ina Grigorieva. And these days it's really like hundreds of people in Manchester, and we all benefit from each other. There is a technology transfer between different groups, recipes, samples, moving from one group to another. And so this, and there is a sense of unity in the community, and it's really nice to see how people interact. And it's even more enjoyable to see that it's really happening not because there is a structure, but because people and students communicate on their own level, and just seeing new ideas developing from such low level communication is probably the most enjoyable. And of course, seeing that how new ideas being created, it's always lovely.
That's great advice. Finally, Kostya, given the current pandemic, looking back, what advice would you have given yourself at the start of the lockdown?
I think I was trying to sit down and think about myself and how I can do it. I can do it in the long run, but what I realized that what I'm doing usually day by day, doing research, is the most enjoyable, and generating new data and new ideas is the most enjoyable part of my work for me. So I was trying to keep it that way and generate new projects, even though we cannot do the real lab work. And apparently it works. So unfortunately, some of my scientific projects being replaced, maybe 10 or 15% being replaced with more societal, but those are equally important. So staying active and keeping your brain occupied is the most important thing which you can do during the lockdown.
Definitely. And thank you to all of those that submitted questions. And Kostya, thank you for taking the time to answer them. It's been really interesting. Take care.
Great. Thanks a lot. Thank you so much.